Hare Krishna. So, yesterday we discussed about how Gop Kumar went up to Brahmaloka, Saptaloka. And in Saptaloka, what happened? Gop Kumar became Lord Brahma. And there he was getting the association of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The Supreme Personality of Godhead in Saptaloka has a relationship with Brahma like Brahma is his son and he is the father. How did Brahma appear? Brahma appeared from the navel of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Garbhodokshai Vishnu. So in that respect, the Lord is the father of Brahma. So Gop Kumar, having assumed the position of Brahma, he was considering that now that I have found the Lord who is like my father, I have achieved the ultimate goal of my existence. So, and he felt that I will always stay here, I will never leave this place. But then one day the Lord told him, Gop Kumar, you go to Vrindavan. Vrindavan is very dear to me. Mathura, Vrindavan is very, very dear to me. And there in Vrindavan, you will also find your spiritual master who is very dear to me. So in this way, the Lord asked him to go to Vrindavan. Which Vrindavan? Bhauma Vrindavan, the Vrindavan in the earth planet. So being instructed by the Lord in this way, Gop Kumar came to Vrindavan. Now, the time in Brahmaloka, in Saptaloka is, one day of Brahma is what? One day of Brahma is 1000 Chaturyuga. So Gop Kumar stayed in there for how many days? Not days, he stayed there for months. Maybe he even stayed there for years. So when he came here, he found that the entire situation changed completely. The planet, the universe, material universe, especially the earth planet, has gone through so many annihilations and reformation that the whole place has changed. But Vrindavan is exactly the same. There was no change in Vrindavan. So this is an indication that this Vrindavan Golok is an extension or expansion of the spiritual Vrindavan. The spiritual sky is unchanging and Vrindavan also is unchanging. Nothing changes, it remains the same. Of course, Loi Bazaar will come and go and all those places will come and go, but actual Vrindavan, the place of the Lord's pastimes, which is covered by the illusory concept of Maya, illusory influence of Maya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur describes, like it says, like a curtain. With our material eyes, we will see only that curtain. In that, we will see all these marketplaces, shops, and people. three-wheelers, motor cars, billboards. But that is not the real Vrindavan. That is just an external covering of Vrindavan, like a net that is covering. But penetrating that, when we see the real Vrindavan, then we will see that that Vrindavan is non-different from the spiritual sky. So, Gop Kumar coming back to the coming back to Vrindavan, he found that the place has completely changed. I mean, that place didn't change at all, although the earth planet has completely changed. And he was there. One day he found his spiritual master in a forest. In Vrindavan he was just spending his time meditating, chanting the holy name of the Lord and meditating on his mantra that his spiritual master had given, Gopal mantra. And one day in one of the groves he found his spiritual master. And his spiritual master, he was unconscious in ecstasy. So he tended him, and when he came back to his senses, then he went to take a bath in Jamuna, and he came out from taking the bath, and then he instructed him on how to meditate upon the mantra. And in this way he instructed him on the mantra and the process of meditation on the mantra. And then his spiritual master told him, Gop Kumar, I have given you everything. All I have given you. And as you meditate upon the mantra, gradually they all will become known to you. You got everything, but it will be revealed gradually as you meditate upon the mantra. That means, as you become advanced, as you make spiritual advancement, accordingly, this realization will be revealed in your heart. And in great respect and gratitude, Gop Kumar fell at the feet of his spiritual master offering obeisances. But when he got up, he found that his spiritual master has left. He couldn't find his spiritual master there anymore. But according to the instruction of his spiritual master, Gop Kumar began to meditate upon the mantra. He started to chant the mantra, meditate on the mantra. And as a result of that, gradually, he felt as if his material body just disappeared. All the his material body made of five elements, just disappeared, dissolved. And he started to move with a tremendous speed, as if with the speed of a mind, he started to travel now. The places, all the 14 planetary, the higher planetary systems, all the way up to Satyaloka, where he spent so much time, they all disappeared out of his vision. Gradually. He went beyond Satyaloka. And Satyaloka also, and when he was traversing from a distance, he saw that all these places have different types of happiness, different types of enjoyment. But all those enjoyments, even the enjoyment up to Satyaloka, were just illusory. It's just a temporary concept of enjoyment, but it's not real enjoyment. Then Gop Kumar came to the outer covering of the universe. The first covering is the covering of earth. There Gop Kumar found that earth personified Mother Earth, who is known, who has many names like Dharani, Dharitri, Boshundhara, Prithibi. These are, she is actually a person. This planet Earth is there, but beyond this planet Earth, there is a personality. And that personality, Earth personified, like sometimes you will see some old pictures of Varahadev rescuing the Earth planet. Then we see that on the tusk of Varahadev, there is a female form. That is the Mother Earth. Mother Earth fell. And Varahadev rescued her. So, this earth with paraphernalia and articles, things that are beyond anyone's imagination. We cannot even imagine the kind of articles. With those articles, she was worshipping the Lord as Mahavarahadeva. Earth is worshipping the Lord. In which form? Varahadev. And then Mother Earth asked Gop Kumar, that why don't you stay here? And Gop Kumar saw the opulence of the place, the enjoyment of the place, the inhabitants of that place who are actually the associates of Mother Earth. They were such exalted personalities with so much opulence. And the Lord, they all were worshipping the Lord with great reverence. Then Gop Kumar came to the next layer, next region, the region of water. And there, the articles, the opulence of the place is many, many times more than the opulence of the earth layer. So the universal layer was totally insignificant compared to the opulence of the earth layer. Then the water layer, the opulence is even greater. And there the Lord, there the personified water personified the presiding deity of water or the personality of water was worshipping Matsya, incarnation of the Lord. Then Gop Kumar came to the next region, the region of fire. And there the opulence is far greater than the opulence of the water region. And there the fire personified is worshipping Surya Dev. Then he came to the region of air. So there in that air region, the Lord was being worshipped as Aniruddha. Then he came to the ether layer. There the Lord was being worshipped as Pradyumna. Then he came to the layer of Ahankar, false ego. There the Lord was being worshipped as Shankarshan. And then he came to Mahatattva. There the Lord was being worshipped as Vasudev. So in this way, Gop Kumar found that, you see, he is now going to the spiritual sky. How does one go to the spiritual sky? Can one go to the spiritual sky with his material body? No. With our material body, matter, as long as we are identifying ourselves with matter, we'll not be able to go back to the spiritual sky. By the practicing proper spiritual process, we'll become free from this material body. And then the spiritual body, free from the bondage of material body, will become qualified to go back to the spiritual sky. That body can move so fast. Like, mind you, that mind also is matter. Now the speed with which the spiritual body can move is faster than the speed of mind. Consider the speed of mind, how fast it is. In no time you can go to America, right? In no time you can go to any place. That is the speed of mind. But the spiritual body, with the speed with which that moves, that's far greater than the speed of mind. So this way Gop Kumar now started to travel. Now can you imagine Swarga Loka, how far it is? Then beyond Swarga Loka, yesterday we discussed, beyond Swarga Loka is Maharloka, beyond Maharloka is Janaloka, beyond Janaloka is Tapaloka, beyond Tapaloka is Sataloka. Sataloka is the topmost region of the universe. Now Gop Kumar just went through this up to Sataloka in no time, in a very short time. He just went past. Then the universe has 8 coverings. Ashta Avaran. What are those coverings of the universe? Coverings of the universe are the subtle layers of the elements. Here it is, earth is there, but there also is the earth. But in a subtle form. Then the water, then fire, then air, then ether, then ahankar, and then mahatattva. These are the 7 layers. And the Lord in each layer, and those areas are not empty. The earth layer, that layer is full of residents, full of living entities. Jai Shri Shri Gaur Nitai ki jai, Jai Shri Shri Radha Madan Mohan ki jai, Jai Shri Shri Krishna Balaram ki jai. So these are all very, very important informations that we are receiving from the scriptures. Are these fairy tales? No. This is science. The scientific informations, reality. Someday when we go there, we'll find, yes, it's there. Just as we heard, just as we read. So in this way, Gop Kumar went beyond the 7 coverings of the universe. There he saw the Lord is being worshipped as Varahadev, as Matsya incarnation, Meena, then as Surya, then as Aniruddha, Pradyumna, Shankarshan and Vasudev. Then Gop Kumar came to a region which was dark. But he felt very happy there. Because that darkness was like the complexion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It was not dark. It has a very soothing color. Although it appeared to be dark, but it is visible. It's beyond our imagination. To us, dark means dark. And mind you, this region that Gop Kumar went to is actually beyond Surya Mandal. This universe, general part of the universe, general aspect of the universe, is lit up by sun. So the area, the region that is lit up by sun is known as Surya Mandal. But this region is beyond the region of the sun. And final layer appeared to be like dark, but it was not. But it's a very beautiful region. And Gop Kumar felt an intense joy. आप लोग मंदिर दर्शन के लिए आए हैं और अभी तो 15 मिनट बाद खुलेगा. अब आप लोग बैठिए. हरे कृष्ण. So in this way Gop Kumar just came to the final layer of the universe, and this is the layer of the Maya Devi's layer, Mahamaya's region. And he found that Mahamaya, there Maya personified, is worshipping the Lord in his Mohini Murti form. The Maya's worshipable form is the Mohini Murti. And when she finished the worship, she was very pleased to see Gop Kumar, and she offered Gop Kumar some inconceivable articles. Like, what are those articles? Those articles are the Yoga Siddhis, like Anima, Laghima, Mahima, Prapti, Prakamya, etc. And then she told him that if you want liberation, then I am the giver of liberation. And if you want devotion, then that also I give as the potency of the Lord, as the servant of the Lord, as the sister of the Lord. So, and she invited Gop Kumar to stay there. But Gop Kumar just neglected her offer. And then Gop Kumar came to a region which is so full of light that Gop Kumar felt as if he was becoming blind. He couldn't, it was such a glaring light. He just closed his eyes. What is that region? Brahma Jyoti. He came to the region of Brahma Jyoti, and it was all so glaring light, and in that light he couldn't, sometimes he could see the manifestation of the Lord. Just deep dark light, deep glaring light, brilliant light, but then he would see the form of the Lord as if that is the center of all that light. And this way, sometimes he was seeing the form, sometimes he was not seeing the form. And sometimes he felt that he was just about to merge into that light. And then he prayed to the Lord. And he came to his consciousness by being touched by the toenails of the Lord. And he came out of his merging state. So this is, Gop Kumar actually felt that that was a kind of a very frightening situation. Like he was about to lose his consciousness. All along he found the Lord. The Lord in some form or the other, the Lord was present. But now he couldn't find, he couldn't constantly see the Lord. The Lord's form was sometimes coming, sometimes disappearing. When the Lord's form was disappearing, he was about to lose his consciousness and merge into this light. So that is how it is to be merged into Brahma Jyoti. Devotees do not want to merge into Brahma Jyoti. Why? Because if one merges into Brahma Jyoti, then he loses the opportunity to serve the Lord. So what is the most important business? To become the Lord or to become the servant of the Lord? So in Brahma Jyoti we may tend to think that we have become the Lord. I am this. I am Brahma. I am the cause of everything. Sarvam Khalidam Brahma. And Aham Brahmasmi. So Gop Kumar was in a state like that when he was kind of losing his consciousness in Brahma Jyoti. And he was remembering the mercy of the Lord at that time. And as a result of that remembrance, he retained his identity as a servant of the Lord. And then all of a sudden Gop Kumar heard of some sound of singing, of music with instruments. And then he saw a very wonderful personality descending from above. That personality was, his complexion was like camphor white. His complexion was white as camphor. He was sitting on a bull and his body was smeared with ashes. His hair was matted, and he was wearing the moon as his crown, and he was surrounded by his associates, and Uma Devi Gauri was sitting on his lap. So Gop Kumar was very moved by seeing that person, and he just offered his respect to him. But he wondered who he was. Then the chief associate of this personality smiled at him and he said that, Gop Kumar, the cowherd, you do not know who this is. This is Lord Shiva. And then he started to sing the glory of Lord Shiva. That how he is the giver of liberation. He is the Lord of the universe. And in this way, he started to reveal the identity of Lord Shiva. And at one point, he explained to him that there is no difference between Krishna and Shiva, Hari and Hara. And the same personality. But in one personality as Hari, he is receiving the worship, he is the Lord, and as Hara, he is the devotee of the Lord. And then Gop Kumar felt that now his life has reached its perfection. He found the association of Lord Shiva, who is not different from the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But then he saw some personalities with four arms, beautiful bluish complexion, wearing yellow garments. They're coming down. They just arrived there. And all the associates of Lord Shiva immediately offered obeisances to them. Lord Shiva embraced them. And while he embraced them, he fainted. He lost, in ecstasy, he lost his consciousness. So Gop Kumar began to wonder, who are these people? Then Parvati looked at Ganesh and indicated him to instruct him who are these personalities. So Ganesh informed that these are the residents of Vaikuntha. After having the darshan of the Lord, they all are going to different universes. Some universes are very small, where a four-headed Brahma rules over the universe. Some universes are ruled by eight-headed Brahmas, some are by 16-headed Brahmas, and accordingly their size increases. The universe that is ruled over by eight-headed Brahma is double the size of the four-headed Brahma's domain. The one who is dominated by 16-headed, that Brahmanda is double the size of eight-headed. And this way there are universes with thousands of headed Brahmas, millions of headed Brahmas. And he saw that they are just going to all those universes. And Ganesh explained that they go there to give protection to those who have taken shelter of the Lord. These Vishnu Dutas are actually patrolling everywhere. And whenever the devotees are in distress, they immediately come to their rescue. And if a devotee even chants the Naam Abhash, Naam Abhash, the chanting the name, just the reflection of the name, not the name, even the reflection or the shadow of the name, at the time of death, they come and rescue him. So in this way, Ganesh began to explain the glory of the Vishnu Dutas. And then Gop Kumar was instructed again to go back to Vrindavan, Bhoma Vrindavan. And anyway, to cut it short, Gop Kumar then after Shiva Loka, so we are getting the geography of the material and spiritual nature. What did we find? The material nature has many, many universes. And beyond each universe, there is an outer part of the universe, there are eight coverings of the universe. And beyond the universe is Brahma Jyoti. Actually, Chaitanya Charitamrita is explaining that beyond the universe is actually all the universes is the Viraja River. So Viraja River can also be identified. Viraja River actually is the causal ocean. The causal ocean. Beyond the causal ocean is Brahma Jyoti. And in Brahma Jyoti, above Brahma Jyoti is the abode of Lord Shiva. And above the abode of Lord Shiva is the abode of Sri Hari, Vaikuntha. You remember in Brahma Samhita also this explained, Goloko namni nijadhamni tale jatasya Devi Mahesha Haridhama Shuteshu Teshu. So here also we are getting the same description. So when Gop Kumar came to Vaikuntha, at the gate he saw the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And he immediately fell at his feet. He thought that he saw a four-armed personality. And he thought that that was the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So he fell down offering obeisances, offering prayers to Him. That, O my Lord, O Supreme Personality of Godhead, please be merciful unto us. But that personality immediately covered his ears and said, No, I am not the Supreme Personality of Godhead. I am just his servant of the servant of his servant. So Gop Kumar was surprised. And saying that, the person immediately ran inside. So Gop Kumar then went inside, and there he saw another person just came. No, he didn't go inside. He just saw one person came on a spaceship, and he came out of the vehicle, the spaceship, that kind of a chariot, celestial chariot that flies. So Gop Kumar just came out of that chariot, and from the chariot he saw that a personality, that he saw the Supreme Personality of God, it came down. So Gop Kumar immediately offered obeisances, and that person also became very embarrassed and started to say, no, I am not the Lord. By saying that, he just ran inside. And Gop Kumar was very surprised. So the point is that in Vaikuntha, the residence has the same form as Narayan. They have four arms, they look exactly the same. This is called Sarupya Mukti. The same form as the Lord. Look the same as the Lord. So that's the risk. The gatekeeper of Vaikuntha looks like the Lord. The residents of the Vaikuntha look the same. And that's why Gop Kumar couldn't actually find out. He was completely confused. And then as Gop Kumar went in, somebody took mercy upon him. And he said, we are the servants of the Lord. Come. And he took him to the Lord. And he saw Lord was sitting on a throne with Lakshmi Devi. And as Gop Kumar saw him, Gop Kumar fainted. Then Lakshmi Devi came and tended Gop Kumar, brought him back to his senses, calling him a child, and very affectionately took him to the Lord. And in this way, Gop Kumar arrived in Vaikuntha. He was receiving so much mercy from the Lord. And in this way, Gop Kumar started to spend his time in Vaikuntha. So one day some residents of Vaikuntha told him, Gop Kumar, now you are in Vaikuntha, why are you still maintaining the earthly form? So you have Jai Shri Shri Krishna Balaram Ki Jai, Jai Shri Shri Radha Madan Mohan Ki Jai, Jai Shri Shri Gaur Nithai Ki Jai. So this way Gop Kumar then just came to they asked Gop Kumar to take the Vaikuntha form, that is Sarupya, like all the other people. And they also, but Gop Kumar didn't want that. He just wanted to maintain that same form. And Gop Kumar sometimes would call out to the Lord as Gopal, Govinda, and in a friendly way he would call. And the residents of Vaikuntha would tell him, no, you shouldn't do that. You shouldn't address the Lord like that. So the point is, Gop Kumar's mood is Vrindavan mood. Even in Vaikuntha, he is not, whereas Vaikuntha mood is the mood of awe and reverence. And that's why we can, anyway, this will become revealed afterwards. So in this way, Gop Kumar went to Vaikuntha and he started to reside there, along with the residents of Vaikuntha, receiving the love and affection of the Lord. And the Lord also had a very special kind of a relationship or very special kind of attitude towards Gop Kumar, which was quite surprising to others. And the Lord sometimes would not display that kind of a mood in front of others because He knew that they wouldn't understand this attitude. And in this way, Gop Kumar arrived in Vaikuntha, but although he was in Vaikuntha, his heart was not satisfied. He was there, but his heart was still not satisfied. Why? Because his goal is Vrindavan. So that is the thing that will happen. Even if we go to Vaikuntha, we will not be satisfied. We will want to, unless we reach Vrindavan, our hearts will not be satisfied. Fortunately or unfortunately, we have got the information of Vrindavan by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Therefore, we will not be able to settle for anything less. So this is how Gop Kumar's journey has been so wonderfully described by Srila Sanatana Goswami in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, which is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. So you are understanding how this is Srimad Bhagavatam? How this is? Bhagavatam is actually a journey that will take us back to the spiritual sky, the topmost region of the spiritual sky, Golok Vrindavan. Thank you very much. Does anybody have any question? Take the mic.
I have a few questions. First is that if this journey Gop Kumar has gone through in his days, but hasn't he encountered the three Vishnus, the three Vishnu forms of the material nature that he had preparatory to meet together in his journey?
What happened? I couldn't get that.
I mean, the three Vishnu forms.
Yeah. No, he didn't. You can say that in Brahma Loka he actually encountered Sahasra Shesha Purusha, not really Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Sahasra Shesha. But then he didn't encounter Vishnus in that way.
And there was when a spiritual soul gets perfected and especially this one, every devotee is going to go back to God, so Golok Vrindavan, do they have to actually go through all these steps or not necessarily?
There are different ways of going back. Some Prabhupada said sometimes it is like waking up from a dream. When you wake up from a dream, then what happens? Do you go through some space? It's just from one state to another state. So, with some it can be like that. Some can go like this. And also there are two types of liberations, Krama Mukti and Sadhya Mukti. Krama Mukti means gradual. Gradual liberation, going from as it has been described here. But in some cases it can be just immediate, waking up. In some cases we'll find ourselves taking birth in a cowherd family, in some place, in some universe where Krishna's pastimes is going on. We'll be born in the cowherd family and will be able to participate in Krishna's pastimes. And by participating in Krishna's pastimes, we will achieve our ultimate perfection and then go back to Golok Vrindavan. This has been explained as in relation to when Krishna played his flute, some gopis could not go because the doors were locked. Their family members locked the doors from outside. So they couldn't go, therefore they left their bodies. So here we have to understand that that they are, by living this body, their body, they achieve their ultimate spiritual perfection and enter into Krishna's Vrindavan Leela. I thought you had two questions. Carry on.
There was the living entities in these layers.
Huh?
He said that the seven layers are also full of living entities.
Also for living entities?
Also full of living entities.
Yeah.
And these are conditioned souls or?
Almost liberated souls.
And final question, the Vaikunthas and the Bhagavan looks similar in the
nature.
It may be kind of a stupid question, but in the Vaikuntha and the Bhagavan looks similar.
Vaikuntha?
In the Vaikunthas, everyone looks similar.
Okay.
To the Lord. Is there no individuality and how do they...
Yeah, you see, those who live there, they can see the differences. But for a layman, they look the same. Right? Say for example, if somebody comes from another planet, to him, all the human beings will look the same. Because they have two arms, two legs, one head. Right? They'll look the same. Because they're not close enough to see the differences. But when you come close, then you can see the difference. Like an example is that... That I can say the experience that I had when I first came to Mayapur. There were two brothers, Pankajangri Prabhu and Jananivas Prabhu, and both of them looked the same to me. I couldn't make out who is who, but then gradually I began to see who is Paniva, the difference between two of them. Okay, any other question? Yes, Nitai Chandra, give him the mic.
Just one small question. Actually, you mentioned the air here, which was like dark. Is that the causal ocean?
Air?
The air layer which Gopikumar went through.
The eighth layer, the final layer, yeah.
So that was a causal ocean, or
no? It's beyond before causal ocean.
Because in the geography also, like we see causal ocean coming, and then that's where Mahavishnu is like now, and then the
Brahma Jyoti. No, the causal ocean is beyond the universe. This is the covering of the universe. Beyond the covering is the causal ocean.
My question is that we did not get a description of the causal ocean, like while going out, we came to the Brahma Jyoti in Kailash. But...
Yeah, because that region, there was no relation to his journey, right? Like it's similar, like almost, because it is so close to causal ocean, it's almost causal ocean. Right? But still it's the universe. And then the next thing is that he sees the Brahma Jyoti. There is no description of his swimming. Yes, Gauranga Priya.
और हम कृष्ण भक्ति कर रहे हैं,
फिर हम तुलसी की जो प्रेयर करते हैं उसमें विष्णु भक्ति प्रतिदि क्या कहते हैं, विष्णु प्रतिदि सत्य होते हैं, विष्णु भक्ति का मिलने से हमें वैकुंठ भी मिल सकता है।
या विष्णु भक्ति, देखो विष्णु और कृष्ण में तो कोई अंतर नहीं है, बल्कि शास्त्र में, क्योंकि शास्त्र में यह श्लोक का उल्लेख ऐसे हुआ है तुलसी देवी के विषय में, तो इसलिए विष्णु भक्ति हम बोलते हैं, बल्कि हमारा चाहना है कृष्ण भक्ति, परंतु शास्त्र, क्योंकि शास्त्र में है विष्णु भक्ति, इसलिए हम विष्णु भक्ति ही बताते हैं, बल्कि हमारा मन की भावना है कृष्ण भक्ति। हाँ, नो इट्स नॉट कंप्लीट, वी टू मोर डेज, टुमारो एंड डे आफ्टर टुमारो, देयर इज अ लॉट टू गो एक्चुअली। This description that we have. Yeah, we have to understand that Sanatana Goswami is giving us a complete understanding. After all, what he is doing is, he is giving us Srimad Bhagavatam in an enlarged way, magnified way, yet in a simplified way. Simplified yet magnified. Like that's why, you know, he is not going directly to the point. He is gradually reaching the ultimate destination for our clarity, for our clarification. Yes, Radharani. Not floating, flying.
Flying over the universe. And they come and meet to the rescue of the devotees. So is this the equivalent of the Western philosophies of religion, what they refer to as angels?
Well, you see, in the Western concept, they do not really have a proper understanding of the spiritual sky. What they think, spirituals, their understanding is heavenly planets, heaven, which is a part of the material universe, Swargaloka. And the angels are the creatures of, like, angels are more like Gandharvas and all those creatures, not the residents of Vaikuntha.
So when the angels come to the assistance of people on the earth planet, so the Gandharvas also come and help them?
The question is, where do they take them? Like, you can say even the policemen are assisting people, right? But are the policemen same as Vishnudutas? No, why not? Because of the extent of their jurisdiction. So you see, if you do not have the understanding of Vaikuntha, how will you ever understand the residents of Vaikuntha and their activities? So that is the point. The angels that they are talking about are, because they are destined, you see, what are they talking about, spiritual sky, or they are talking about heaven? They are not talking about spiritual sky as such. They are talking about heaven, a place which is above this planet, but full of enjoyment. So that is heavenly planet. And But you know, Vishnu Dutas, they are the guardian angels in the real sense, who gives us the ultimate shelter. Anyway, that is, you know, if we see, if we analyze the extent of their knowledge or their description, then we have to come to this conclusion. You see, in the Western concept, they don't have any understanding beyond this material nature. There's no need to get into that. You get the point. Yeah. How?